Hello and welcome to Van Diemen's Land Model Bench and my Badger Stynylrez review. Badger Stynylrez has been getting a lot of good publicity lately with folks like Phil Flory from Flory Models singing his praises, and I suspect he alone has sold probably the whole UK supply of the stuff. Paul over at Scale Models International has been equally enthusiastic. Unfortunately for me, I've already have two lots of primers in the form of Ammo by MIG and Alclad 2. And the truth is, my wife would kill me if I threw the stuff out, and at the rate I use primers, I've probably got three, maybe four years supply of the stuff left to go. So the opportunity to try out Stynylrez was looking fairly remote. Fortunately, a friend, Michael B, decided he needed some primer and ordered a couple of bottles of the new Stynylrez. And he was kind enough to give me a small jar of the primer so I could at least try it out. Badger Stynylrez comes in six colours. There's your more common grey, black and white, as well as red, green and yellow. It's sold in 60ml and 120ml bottles. At present I'm building the Airfix's 1/24 scale Hawker Hurricane, and I'm doing some of the smaller parts, so this seemed a good opportunity to try out the new Badger primer. Now, if there's one thing Airfix knew how to do with this kit, it was to how to make injection pin marks on every single piece of the kit. I'm not kidding. Several marks if they could fit them all in. So for the test, I prepared the large undercarriage doors the way I would normally, which is to say that I use Flory Model sanding sticks to finish off the and hide the injection pin marks, and then I finished off with one of Flory Model's polishing sticks to give a nice smooth surface. For the smaller undercarriage doors, I didn't use the final polishing step, so there are still scratches in the plastic. I did that because I was kind of curious to see how Stynylrez would deal with that. My airbrush for the test is a Pash Talon dual action airbrush with a 0.38 needle. Now, I found that generally my Pash airbrushes like to run 5 psi or so higher pressures than other brand airbrushes I've used. So I started the test with the compressor set to about 25 psi. The Stynylrez itself is actually quite thick, so later I bumped this pressure up during the spraying by about another 4 psi or so. The Stynylrez was very easy to spray and it went on with very good coverage. First I sprayed a light misty coat on the parts to break down the surface tension, and a few minutes later went back over the parts with a heavier coat. It turned out that the coverage was so good, in fact, that all I needed to do really was just that. There was no need to go back and give a third or fourth coat. In my opinion, you won't use a lot of the Stynylrez to cover your model, so it should prove quite economical to use. While I was at it, I decided to do a bit of a flood test, so I sprayed on more of the Stynylrez than I would on many of the other primers that I own. So much, in fact, that this almost certainly would have resulted in the primer pooling and leaving some drip marks if I'd used the Ammo by MIG or Alclad 2 primers. Stynylrez, however, self-leveled beautifully and is easily the best I've seen or used in this respect. It was very easy to get a smooth finish with the Stynylrez primer. So if you've struggled with primers in the past, this fact alone I think is going to win you over with this product. In the parts I'd not polished the scratches out of, these scratches were still clearly visible after the primer had dried. This means, of course, that you won't lose any fine detail on your model when spraying with this primer, but you will have to be very thorough with your model's preparation, as any imperfections are likely to show through. Also, just a note of caution, like all good primers, Stynylrez is what I would call very sticky, which is to say that if you touch it with your fingers, then anything you touch after that with your fingers is going to end up with some wonderful Stynylrez fingerprints. So you've been warned. Cleaning the airbrush required a complete strip down, which is what I do with any of the primers anyway. I first tried some Mr. Color Thinner just to see how that would work, and it didn't work very well. Next I tried a lot of modelers' favourites, the Tamiya Lacquer Thinner, and that was better, but not perfect. Finally, for the test, I used my default airbrush cleaner, which is Tamiya's airbrush cleaner, and that instantly dissolved the primer and worked very well at cleaning all the parts of the airbrush. So for me at least, there were no dramas there. Although the Pash Talon had worked well with the Stynylrez primer, it did struggle a bit, and the cleaning is always a bit of a pain with dual-action airbrushes. So I wonder what it would be like to use the Stynylrez with a single-action airbrush. Enter my 35-plus-year-old Pash H airbrush. Now, this is the second airbrush I've ever owned, and it's been through the wars, quite frankly. After a couple of years of, well, actually a couple of decades of neglect, and a little bit of a scrub-up, and that's all basically I've ever done to it. These airbrushes are basically bulletproof, and it just keeps on soldering on. The Pash H had the number one needle fitted, and that's what I use for the test. I'm not too sure what the diameter needle that actually is, but I do know it's the finest one you can get for the H airbrush. I bumped the compressor pressure up to about 35 psi, and I sprayed the opposite side of the main undergarage doors. The results were very impressive, with a beautifully smooth finish, and of course I got the easier cleanup with the single action airbrush. I was so impressed with this combination that I'd actually recommend that if you're going to use Stynylrez as your primer, you should give serious consideration to getting a single-action airbrush just for spraying the primer. And make sure you get one with a large needle, about 0.4 or even a 0.5. The primer was dry to the touch in a few minutes and could be handled. Badgers say that you can paint over it in around 30 minutes from applying it, and it cures in around 24 hours. I wouldn't try and sand it until at least you've given it that 24 hours drying time. You read and see a lot of products hyped up in this hobby, and sometimes you end up disappointed when you finally get to try them out. But in this case, I wasn't disappointed. Badger Stynylrez works beautifully, and is by far the best primer I've ever used so far. I'm impressed enough that when my existing stockpile of primer is exhausted, I'll certainly be going with the Badger Stynylrez without a moment's hesitation. So in conclusion, I'd have to say the Badger Stynylrez is excellent, and comes highly recommended. Just as a footnote, Ultimate Modelling Products just recently announced that they're also going to be distributing the Badger Stynylrez in grey, white and black under their branding as Ultimate Primer. Now, it's exactly the same stuff made by Badger for them, so it might help with availability if you can't get the Badger branded primer where you live.